Hello, everyone. God has an encouraging word just for you today. I want to share with you how to have limitless living. In other words, how to expand your thinking in such a way where you begin to live without limits. That's today's encouraging word. This is a time and a season where God is saying, be fruitful, multiply, increase your harvest, take dominion. Everything that he spoke to Adam and Eve in Genesis chapter 1, verse 28, he gave specific directions to them before the fall of man, that they were to be setting themselves up for increase. And so I want to share with you how important it is to live in a place of time redemption, where time is redeemed so you can enter back in to the space and place of the Garden of Eden. See, Adam and Eve had everything at their disposal. It was self-sustaining. It was lush. It was an environment that was limitless, without limits. The limits did not come until the enemy convinced them that the one tree that was in the garden that God said, do not touch, the one safe, healthy boundary that God put up, do not touch so that you can continue to live limitlessly. If you touch that, you will have limits upon you. The enemy came and confused Eve, confused Adam, and they began to disobey the Lord, take from the fruit of that tree, and they then put limits on them. These limits became confining. They became depressive. They became something that stopped them from their development. They went into arrested development. They could not go any further until they confessed their sin to God and began to be set up then for a life of redemption. Now, I say a life of redemption as in the fact that before they departed from the Garden of Eden, there was a flaming sword with cherubim guarding it that was put on the outside of the garden. So through relationship with Jesus, we then enter back into the Garden of Eden. So through relationship with Jesus, time is redeemed. And the redemption of time is very, very important, because if time is redeemed, then we again are placed back in the Garden of Eden. We have been given dominion, as the Lord spoke to Adam and Eve in Genesis chapter 1, verse 28. He says, you have dominion. Be fruitful, multiply, replenish, subdue, and have dominion over the fish, the birds, everything that's in this garden, over all of this. I, God, have given you authority. And so we then gain back our dominion through what Jesus has done for us. He has redeemed the time that Adam and Eve cut us loose from. Yes, they positioned us for a death for shortened time. But what God has done through Jesus Christ is time has now been lengthened. Time has now been expanded. We are now in a place where we can fully step into that dominion if we make a choice to do that. And so really, that's what today's prophetic word is all about. It's time to step into the dominion that God is calling you. Now, this is a word that is profound for us every single day. But what's incredibly important is here in this month of Cheshvan, it is definitely a month where the Lord says, be fruitful, multiply, and increase. It is a time of increase and harvest. So we need to know how to take dominion again. So if you're not living in a space where you are fulfilling God's plan for taking the dominion over which God has called you to rule over, to reign over, if you are in a place where things seem to be out of control, they seem to be depressive or full of anxiety or full of confusion, or it looks like you're under constant enemy attack, and these types of things, that's what God's saying. It's time to come in and begin to take dominion again so you can begin to live without limits. See, when we take dominion, we put up protective boundaries around ourselves so that we can live in the limitless place that God is calling us to live. He wants us to live as though we're seated with Christ in heavenly places. So I just want to encourage you today. The Lord wants you to know it is time to live without limits. In other words, you don't have to be working so hard, toiling so much, pushing and pressuring yourself where it becomes so difficult for you to live your life in a space and place of joy and in a space and place of rest. All that comes with living a dominion life, kingdom dominion life. There's rest. There's peace, there's authority that is there. And that's what God wants for us. So if your life is out of order in this regard, it's time to just say, Lord, forgive me. Please position me to get back into proper alignment with you. Lord, I thank you so much because of what Jesus has done. Time is redeemed. And now, if I walk diligently or circumspectly, according to Ephesians chapter 5, verse 15, if I walk this way, Lord, you're going to position me for greater advancement, greater reigning and ruling. My boundaries are going to be expanded in a safe place with you. See, that's what the Lord wants. He wants your home. He wants your business. He wants your relationships to be in a safe place where you can rule and reign and do the things that God has called you to do with all of the resources that he's called you to do it in. He's called you to be a giver. He's called you to be positioned to honor him with your substance. He's called you to step into all of those things. But we need to know and understand that through Jesus' death, burial, and resurrection, he bought all that back for us. So now may be a time where you just simply have to come before the Lord and say, God, I'm not living like this. God wants you to live like this. He wants you to live in the fullness. He wants you to live in the completion. He wants you to live in nothing missing, nothing broken. He wants you back in the Garden of Eden with him in a full-on relationship that Jesus Christ has bought for you and shed his blood for. But we got to be in a place and position where we recognize this. So I want you just now, just with me, I want you just to confess, Lord, please forgive me. I have not been living in the fullness that you've called me to, in the kingdom dominion. I've been scared. I've been frightened. I've been doing things that I shouldn't be doing. I've been concerned about this and concerned about that, but I've not been properly positioning myself for alignment with you, Lord, so that I can bring about kingdom dominion and rulership in the world that you have called me to rule. See, God's calling you to rule. He's calling you to rule as a father, as a mother, as a daughter, as a son. He's calling you to rule in your business. He's calling you to rule in your relationships. He's calling you to rule in your finances. But you've got to get things in order. And the first of that is confessing, repenting, and properly positioning yourself to be one that is a good tree that brings about good fruit. In other words, if inside's not right, outside's not going to be right. So begin to start getting it in alignment with the Lord, and you're going to begin to start seeing that multiplication. And there is so much that's coming to you. God says this is a time of harvest. It's a time of multiplication. We got to know how to manage what is multiplying. We got to know how to manage this harvest. We got to know how to continue it flowing and advancing. But how are you going to know that if you're not properly positioning yourself? So you don't want the enemy to come in and steal your harvest. Your harvest is what God has given you to now manage. We got to be a good steward of it. So get in alignment with the Lord so you can become a good steward of that which you are called to manage. So live without limits, but live in alignment with the Lord so you can manage and be a good steward. So I'm going to pray for you right now. Good stewardship is coming upon you. Living without limits is coming upon you. Jesus has made that way. All you've got to do is properly position yourself in alignment with the Father. So Lord, I thank you right now for my friend who's watching. I thank you, Lord, that they have a harvest before them. They have increase and multiplication. They have a land that you are calling them to manage, Father. And I thank you, Lord, for all that you brought before them. Help put them in alignment, Father. Anything that you're bringing into the mind of those that are watching this right now, Father, help them come into proper alignment right now, Father. I thank you. See, the Lord's popping things in your mind right now. He's showing you certain things that need to be fixed. He wants to fix them. He wants to put them in proper perspective. He wants to give you truth and the word in order to combat those lies of the enemy so you can begin to start managing your harvest. Father, I thank you right now. My friend is a good steward. They have a heart of stewardship, Father. They want to manage the things that you have given them. And so, Father, I praise you and I thank you right now for proper alignment with your word, proper alignment with who you are, Lord, so that the harvest shall be managed in the mighty name of Jesus. Woo! I feel the power and presence of the Lord right there. Share this with a friend today. I want you to hashtag manage my harvest. That's right. Hashtag manage my harvest. See, God's teaching you to live without limits so you can manage his harvest properly. When you live without limits, it means you have everything in order. You have confessed, you have repented, you have come into alignment with the Lord. You're making a fresh start and you're now managing all that he's given you, because God wants to give you way more than what you have right now, and he needs you to be a really good steward of that. So that's the encouraging word for today. Have a blessed day.